Hello everyone. This is the second part of distance protection. For those who haven't watched part 1, I recommend them to watch part 1 before part 2. As in the part 1, we have described what is distance protection and listed the various types of distance relay. Also, we have described impedance relay there. And the remaining two types of distance relay, that is reactance relay and Mohr relay, will be described in this part 2. Starting with the reactance relay. To the second type of relay, distance relay, that is reactance relay. Similarly, it will also contain two units, or two operating quantities. First will be the current element, overcurrent element, which will be producing the positive torque, and that too will be directly proportional to the square of the current. The next unit will be a current voltage directional element, which will be equal to the positive torque produced, and it will either aid or oppose the overcurrent element depending whether the phase angle between the voltage and current is what. A reactance relay is also called as overcurrent relay with a directional element. The directional element is so inbuilt here that it will develop the maximum negative torque when the current will exactly lag behind the voltage by 90 degrees. A typical reactance relay is shown here using induction cup structure. It is having a 4-pole structure, 1, 2, 3 and 4-pole structure, carrying the operating, polarizing and the restraining coils. The restraining coil will get energized by the PT, that is your potential transformer, where the operating and the polarizing coils will get energized from the current transformer, that is your CT. The operating torque is developed by the interaction of fluxes due to current carrying coils. Here current carrying coils are 2, 3 and the 4 one, as they are receiving the operating and the polarizing coils. 2, 3 and 4 pole are receiving the operating and polarizing coils, which are fed from the CT, hence they will be developing the operating torque. The restraining torque is produced by the interaction of fluxes due to poles 1, 2 and 4, means it will be having a combination of restraining coil plus polarizing coil. As we have already seen that the operating torque will be directly proportional to your I square, and the restraining torque will be a combination of V and I and the angle between them, represented by the cos theta minus. The torque equation of the reactance relay. As we have already described the torque equation of impedance relay, we can also describe the torque equation of reactance relay in the following way. It is represented as K1 I square minus K2 VI cos theta minus 90 minus K3, where K1 I square are the torque produced, are the operating torque produced by the overcurrent element. It is directly proportional to the square of current, whereas K2 VI cos theta minus 90 is the restraining torque produced by the current voltage directional element, and K3 is the spring control effect. The restraining torque and K3, that is your spring control effect constant, is always represented with negative sign, as these are the torque which will be restricting our operating torque. So in a way that when a fault has not occurred in the system, it will not be operating. Theta is defined as positive when I lags behind V, and so the torque equation is modified to as K1 I square minus K2 VI sine theta minus K3. This, when we have neglected the spring control effect, the equation get reduced to this K1 I square minus K2 VI sine theta. During the normal operating condition, or the when balance point is there, the two torques, operating torque and the restraining torque, will be equal to each other. And when we are modifying this equation, we will get a constant K, which will be equals to your Z sin theta. And as we all know, Z sin theta is equals to X, means here the constant, here your reactance is equal to a constant during the normal operating condition. Basically, during a normal operating condition, when you will be measuring the reactance or impedance of a relay, it will be equal to the predetermined or preset value. characteristics of a reactance relay. The characteristics of a reactance relay will be a straight line parallel to R-axis. As you can see in the figure, the positive torque region lies below the operating characteristics, whereas the negative torque region lies above the operating characteristics. If a fault occurs in a region of positive torque, the relay will operate, whereas if the fault point lies in negative torque region, the relay will block it. An important point to be noted here is that the resistance component of the impedance has no effect on the operation of the relay. That is, any point below the operating characteristics, whether above or below R-axis, but it must be below the operating characteristics, will lie in the positive torque region. In the general torque equation represented by T equals to K1 I square minus K2 VI cos theta minus 2 minus K3, if this theta is not exactly equal to 90 degrees, this operating characteristics, which is parallel to R-axis and a straight line, will get changed. It will be a straight line definitely, but it will not be exactly parallel to your R-axis. Such a relay is then will be defined as angle impedance relay. Moving on to the final type of distance relay, that is a mode relay, also known as admittance relay, and also sometimes called as angle impedance relay. Here, the operating torque is produced by the volt ampere element, and the restraining torque is developed solely by the voltage element. And hence, mode relay is a voltage restrained directional relay, as the restraining component or the restraining torque is produced only by the voltage element. That's why it is called as voltage restraint directional relay. A typical Moore relay is represented here using induction cup structure. It is having a four pole structure. The first, second and the four pole structure. First, second and four pole structure are receiving their energization from the potential transformer PT, whereas the third pole is having the operating coil, which is energized by the current transformer, that is CT. The operating torque is developed by the interaction of fluxes due to pole 2, 3 and 4, means polarizing and operating coil, whereas the restraining torque is produced by 1, 2 and 4, the one receiving the energization from potential transformer. Torque equation of Moore relay. In a similar way, just like we have seen the torque equation of impedance and reactance relay, we will be starting here the torque equation of Moore relay. K1 VI cos theta minus tau is representing the operating torque, which is produced by voltage current directional element. K2 V square is the restraining torque produced by the voltage element, and K3 is the spring control effect. Neglecting spring control effect, we can modify this torque equation as here K3 will be equals to 0. Considering for the normal operating condition or at a balance point, you can see the torque equation will be equals to 0. We will be modifying this equation, and at last we will be getting a term Y. Y is the admittance in Moore, which will be equal to your constant K. So this is the torque equation representation of a Moore relay. The characteristic of a Moore relay. The characteristic of a Moore relay is represented by a circle. So that means it is having a circular characteristic, in which a circle passing through the origin, which makes the relay inherently directional. That means the region inside the circle is represented as positive torque region, whereas the region outside the circle is represented as negative torque region. Means the relay will be operating when the impedance seen or measured will fall in this positive torque region. Positive torque region is the region of trip, whereas the negative torque region is the region of block. This is the characteristic of Moore relay in RX plot. But if we will be plotting this characteristics in VG plot, it will be represented by a straight line. The characteristic of a Mohr relay on admittance diagram is therefore a straight line. Thank you all. That's it from my side. We will be continuing with the video lecture, so please stay connected.